Now let's cover two rescuer adult AED for the healthcare professional. We're still going to check the scene for safety, but not just for the rescuers, but also for the usage of the automated external defibrillator. Our gloves are on, we have a one-way valve rescue mask, or in this case, we have a bag valve mask that my second rescuer will be using. There are no combustible gases or liquids, and the patient is not lying in a pool of water that would connect either of the rescuers or both to the patient's body so that when we defibrillate them, we may also be electrocuted. So that's important to understand. If they were, we would move them to a dry ground, pat off their chest to make sure it's dry enough that the pads would adhere to the chest, but other than that, we would be ready to go. Now, we're still going to assess the patient for responsiveness, and the two things I really want you to key in on here is the orchestrated movements of this team approach with the AED and CPR. We want to minimize the delay of compressions to any other action, whether that be using the bag valve mask, setting up the AED, burying the chest, cleaning off the chest. We're minimizing anything that would stop that heart from being compressed and circulating oxygenated blood and oxygen to the parts of the brain and the heart and important organs. So we're going to go ahead and assess our patient now. Sir, can you hear us? Can you hear me? There's no response. Tap and shout on the collarbone. Sir, can you hear me? There's no response. Now, of course, we already have our AED, but if we didn't, we could send somebody to go get an AED and bring it back to us, or a crash cart. In this case, we're going to tell somebody to go activate EMS or call a code, and we're going to get back into our work here. So 911 has been activated, the code has been called, and now we're going to assess this person for normal breathing and a carotid pulse. I check for no more than 10 seconds. The patient, Jody, is not breathing and they do not have a pulse. I'm going into CPR now. 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8.
From person's chest.
7, 8, 9 and 10, 11 and 12 and 13 and 14 and 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I stop only long enough for him to put that pad on and then I'm right back onto my compressions. Continuous chest compressions until we get that put on.
Check connector and pads. Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear.
Clear.
Shock advised. Charging. Everyone stand clear. Everyone stand clear. Push the shock button.
Clear.
Clear.
Shock delivered.
Back onto the compressions right away. Now we're going to do 5 cycles and we're going to incorporate the 2 rescue breaths after 30 compressions. 10 and 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 9, 30.
Breath. Breath.
1 and 2 and 3 and 28, 29, 30. Now keep in mind that by the time the AED reanalyzes, it'll be approximately 2 minutes, which is the ideal time for the compressor to switch with the person who's been giving rescue breaths so that we can have a fresh compressor on the chest. 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Breath. Breath.
Good breaths. 2 and 3 and 4 and 5. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. During this analyzation of the heart rhythm is a perfect time for me to switch the bag valve mask. My partner is going to go ahead and control the shock.
Clear.
Clear. And he goes right into compressions.
1, 2.
And I take over with rescue breaths.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Breath goes in.
Good breath.
Breath goes in.
Good breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And we're going to continue this 30 to 2 CPR. Every 2 minutes switching and coordinating this whole shock CPR rescue breath orchestration of care. It's in minimizing the delay between any action and the next compression that's going to give this circulation of oxygenation the best percentage so that this person has the best chance of survival.